Well, it's a real pleasure for me to have an opportunity to talk to you about the work that's been going on in my laboratory about the role of an arginine methyltransferase called PRMT5 in adult hematopoiesis. The first author of this work, Fan Liu, is a postdoctoral fellow in my lab, and the paper was just published in the Journal of Clinical Investigation. So my lab has been studying the role that histone-modifying enzymes play in hematopoiesis, and we've been focused to a large degree on the non-histone targets of these enzymes. And so in addition to identifying substrates for these enzymes, we're looking at their function in both normal and in malignant hematopoiesis so we can understand the basic processes and how they're subverted in acute leukemia. So to do that, we generated a conditional knockout mouse. And using the MX1 Cre system, we were able to induce the deletion of PRMT5 at about 2 months of age in these mice in the hematopoietic compartment. We found very strikingly that the loss of PRMT5, the major type 2 arginine methyltransferase in mammalian cells, leads to the rapid development of pancytopenia and death of the mice. So by day 15, there's virtually no platelets, no red blood cells, and no white cells in the peripheral blood, and the bone marrow becomes hypoplastic and then aplastic. So in essence, the mice die of aplastic anemia. We've looked at the stem cells and the progenitor cell compartments in these mice, and what we find is a different effect of one population than the other. So initially, we see an increase in the stem cell frequency, and that's measured both by LSK cells and also the long-term HSCs, which are measured by CD48 negative, CD150 positive, lineage negative, SCA1 positive, KIT positive cells. Although these cells increase in frequency, if you take these long-term HSCs and try to rescue another mouse from lethal irradiation, these hematopoietic stem cells don't function. When we looked at the progenitor cells, rather than seeing an increase in number, as you would expect, we saw a dramatic decrease in the number of progenitor cells, and this leads to the pancytopenia. And so the progenitor cells have a defect in their proliferation, and we do not see increase in apoptosis in these cells, but we do see an inability to proliferate, and the cells disappear, and the mice die from pancytopenia. So we've investigated the mechanism by which PRMT5 has this effect in hematopoiesis, doing RNA-seq studies from HSPCs. And what we found is the number one pathway that comes up is cytokine signaling. And so we then began some studies looking at the response of the stem cells, the progenitor cells, and the differentiated cells to cytokines, and we found a profound defect. So if you add these cytokines to the cells and you look for activation of the JAK-STAT pathway, the MAP kinase pathway, or AKT, you see a dramatic decrease in the amount of phospho-STAT5, the amount of phospho-ERK, and the amount of phospho-AKT, showing a very severe defect in signaling. We also see an increase in P53 levels, which we think probably results from the defective signaling. But as I mentioned, we do not see an increase in apoptosis. And in fact, if you cross these mice with caspase 3 null mice, you don't rescue the hematopoietic phenotype. And so we've got some insight into the mechanism, namely this defective cytokine signaling that occurs. But we went another step to look at the cytokine receptors themselves. And we found a few different abnormalities. When we look at the level of expression of c-KIT on these cells, we see a marked decrease in expression. And when we reviewed the RNA-seq data, looking at the FLT3 receptor expression, we found a lot of intron retention, which would lead to a decrease in the expression of FLT3. And so we find by a number of mechanisms, changes in the transcription of cytokine receptors, changes in their level of expression, changes in their splicing, which we think coordinately work together to cause such defective cytokine signaling. So to summarize, we've identified an absolutely essential role for PRMT5. It turns out if you make chimeric mice, where the mice have 50% normal hematopoiesis and 50% of the conditional knockout, that when you knock out the PRMT5 from the CD45.2 cells, that even though the peripheral blood counts don't change because of the normal cells that are present, that over time the CD45.2 HSCs increase in frequency and become less quiescent, but then over time the entire CD45.2 population disappears from the peripheral blood and the bone marrow of the mice. And so even without any kind of homeostatic mechanisms, PRMT5 plays an essential role in adult hematopoiesis. In terms of mechanism, again, we see a profound defect in cytokine signaling, and it's one of the things that we're looking at now in the future to further identify the role of PRMT5 in normal and in malignant hematopoiesis. Thanks very much for listening.